Hello, this is Nishka here. Tell me something, whether it's an important business meeting or your interaction with a client over an email, what sets you apart is how you communicate. So it is important to use business English every time you have any interaction. Today, I am going to share with you these 12 important phrases that will change the way you speak business English. So hear me out. No brainer. It is but obvious that I will sit for campus placement when the time comes. The meaning of this phrase is whenever something is really easy to decide, it is a no-brainer. To give you an example, taking a new job was no-brainer. They offered me more money, better schedule, and more vacations. No strings attached. When you helped your friend in finishing his assignment, you did not expect any favor in return. That means you helped him with no strings attached. The meaning of this phrase is when you do something without expecting a favor in return. Let's take a look at an example. They will let you try the product for free as there are no strings attached. If you don't like it, don't buy it. Not going to fly. You have scored very little marks in your exams and you know that getting in your dream college is not going to be easy. That's the time you can say that it is not going to fly. The meaning of this phrase is, if a solution is ineffective and you're not sure of the result, it is not going to fly. Let's take a look at an example. I don't think that's going to fly. Let's keep generating ideas. Out of the loop. As you were unwell, you could not attend your college for a week. After you came back, you did not know what's happening. That means you were out of the loop. To give you a meaning, when something that a select group of people know and you don't know, it means you are out of the loop. To give you an example, I felt I was out of the loop after being on vacation for 2 weeks. Pink slip. When someone is told to leave the company due to its non-performance or cutting losses, he has been given a pink slip. The meaning of this phrase is when you are told to leave the company. To give you an example, they gave him the pink slip as he was not performing really well. Read between the lines. By seeing your friend's gesture, you understood that she doesn't want to come to the party. But when you asked her, she said yes. When you get hints, that means you read between the lines. The meaning of this phrase is when something you understand that is not told to you directly. A sample statement. He did not say that he's leaving the company, but I can read between the lines. He's not happy here. Second nature. He speaks so well in public that it looks very natural. That means it comes as his second nature. The meaning of the phrase is when someone does it so well that it looks he's born to do it. Let's have a look at an example. She's been a computer programmer for 10 years. Programming is now her second nature. See something through. You prepared really well for your entrance exam, and no matter how tough it was, you're at it. The meaning of this phrase means to be at something even when it is tough. To give you an example, I told my boss that I really want to see the project through and move on to another project. State of the art. The new airport is so well built. Everything is so technologically advanced. It means it was the state-of-the-art infrastructure. The meaning of the phrase is when anything that is very, very advanced and good, it is called state-of-the-art. Let's have a look at a sample statement. We have a brand new state-of-the-art facility in our organization. Touch base. You were going to meet your friend, but because of your interview, you have postponed it. That means you will touch base with your friend next week. The meaning of this phrase is when you make contact with someone. let me present to you a practical example. Let me make a few phone calls to try and get the answer to your question. I will touch base with you next week. Yes, ma'am. Just because you want to be in good books of some important people, you agree to whatever they say, whether you believe in it or no. That's the time you become the yes man. The meaning of this phrase is to agree with someone even when you don't believe in it. Here's a practical example. The company isn't looking to hire someone who'll bring about a lot of changes. All they're looking for is a yes man. To give someone a heads up, whenever you want to inform someone in advance, you kind of give them forewarning. That is what this phrase means. To give someone an advance warning. Let's have a look at an example. Just a heads up about tomorrow. The sales conference will begin at 9 a.m. Don't be late. Aren't these simple and effective phrases that you can use in your day-to-day life? So please start applying them in your communication and keep upgrading your English. Happy learning!